front of you. Sunday school was something that took place before the church service at Holy Trinity back then. And so during church, the kids would either in the nursery or sitting in a pew. Well, at that point, I was married, so Bill and I always believed that kids sitting in the front pew would see what was going on and that would keep them occupied because they'd be interested in what was going on. And then if there was a question, Bill or I could direct them or answer it. Well, so here they were. And then when I had to be up front after becoming a deacon, Bill would sit in front of the girls. By then they were old enough, but they pretty much followed along. Well, now my grandchildren usually sit in the front, and that's due to their mothers, and sometimes for being it's a blessing or a curse, depending on the type of faces. Or my four-year-old Lily will go, "Hi, Grandma." So who is our neighbor? Bella, who also goes to St. Juliana's, was coming up in the car with her mom onto Southern Boulevard and the I-95 overpass, and there's always the same homeless or at least hungry man there. So one morning, Bella said to her mom, "Mom, do we have an extra Capri Sun?" And she said, "Well, yes." And she said, "Well, can I have it? And could you lower my window back here? Because now there's a red light." And now Christy has to stop. And she said, "Well, Bella, what are you doing?" She says, "I want to give this guy out here like Capri Sun. He looks thirsty." That's exactly what Bella did. And the gentleman was gracious and thanked her, and they were on their way. A couple weeks later, they're coming back from school. Same guy at the same stoplight on the I-95 overpass on Southern. Bella says, "Mom, can you stop and give me my lunchbox?" Bella had saved her snacks that day and had an extra Capri Sun. And she says, "Bella, what do you want?" She says, "Well, Mom, I want you to lower my window because he looks not only thirsty, but he looks hungry." She says, "I saved my snacks from school." So out of the lunchbox came what she saved and the Capri Sun, and she said to the guy, "Could you come here, please?" And she gave it to him. She said, "You look hungry and thirsty today." So he thanked her. Bella, till this day, carries extra Capri Suns in the car with the same guy on I-95 overpass, and now he recognizes the car. And he knows Bella's going to give him up, you know, one of the Capri Suns. Who is my neighbor? I would have never guessed a six-year-old grandchild of mine would have thought
gets two muffins. She takes it over to where the gentleman was and sits down in front of him and gives him the coffee and the muffin. And she proceeds to ask, what's going on? How can I be helpful? And he tells her the story, whatever that story is. Well, she shared her bus tokens with him so that he would have enough tokens to go to work so he wouldn't get fired. She also said, can I have your name and phone number, and I would like to call to check on you. And he did that. So later that afternoon, she calls this gentleman on the phone and says, I just want to call and see how you are this afternoon. Are you doing better? And yes, he was, and he thanked her for all that she did, even if it was just listening. Who is my neighbor? In our baptismal covenant, we are called to seek the Christ in each other, to strive for justice and peace. We are called as Christians to go the extra mile. Now I want to bring up what's going on in our community and world, which has changed my sermon completely. Last night there was a verdict. Everybody's been watching George Zimmerman's trial. It's not a secret. It's not happened behind closed doors. The whole thing has been a tragedy. It doesn't matter what side of the family you're on. It's a tragedy. Police officers in Palm Beach County, in Port St. Lucie, in Vero Beach, have been on high alert all week. You see them out and about, waiting. Words of wisdom that our own Archdeacon Bazan has come out with, the Bishop of Central Florida, and our own bishop have prayed for justice and peace. And that those folks present would seek justice and peace. We pray for a peaceful outcome of whatever was to happen. And yet, outside that courtroom at Sanford was those for a conviction and those not for a conviction. What's the right answer? I don't know. I know that there's been a tragedy on both sides. I know that lives have been lost and lives are changed. But again, our baptismal covenant calls us to seek the Christ in each other and to strive for justice and peace. We have elected officials and we have a democratic process in our country. And hopefully we have faith in that system. It may not be the answers that we want or what we expected, but we have a system. We strive to seek the Christ in each other. When George finally meets his maker, whatever happens at that point will be between him and God. For God is the only one that knows what happened. When Trayvon Martin got to heaven, it was only he and God that knew what would happen. Or what did happen. If I were to voice my opinions of my own personal opinion, and it's not your opinion, and we interact negatively with each other, I guess I ask, who is that to serve? My prayer this morning was, please God, more of you and less of me. And I think that needs to be our prayer each and every day of our lives. Please God, more of you and less of me. And to live our lives as Christians and what we are called to be. And we strive, in my prayers, we strive for justice and peace. We strive for mercy, and we strive to seek the Christ in each other. Who is my neighbor? Who is my neighbor? And to live out our lives as Christ is asking us in today's gospel is not to act passively with mercy, but God is asking us to act through what His Son has taught us. We're not being asked to provide mercy or offer mercy and forgiveness once, but each and every day of our Christian lives. That causes us to work a lot harder to live out our lives as Christians. That's what we're asked. I hold up and I honor the decisions of all the people involved. And I honor and hold up our ability to live in a society where we disagree. But I hold up the privilege of being a Christian in today's world to live out our baptismal covenant. Mahatma Gandhi has a quote, and I know I use Mahatma Gandhi a lot, but his quotes speak to me, and they're so human. Your beliefs become your thoughts. Your thoughts become your words. Your words become your actions. Your actions become your habits. Your habits become your values. Your values become your destiny. Jesus said, go and do likewise. Our baptismal covenant calls us and holds us to go and do likewise. To strive for justice and peace. To strive for seeking the Christ in each other. And I guess I hold up to you our baptismal covenant found on page, I think it's 301. I invite you to go back and look at that this week and to see what you promise every time you participate in baptism and to hold it up. all that have been involved in the outcomes of George Zimmerman. For both families have lost. There have been no winners here. Lives have been changed forever. How we deal with